Good morning, students. Today in this biology class of class 10, we'll discuss about the chapter 15. Okay, that is our environment. And in session 1, we'll discuss about the what is environment. Okay, and what are the biodegradable, non-biodegradable, etc. We'll discuss in the first session 1. So what is environment? You know it from class 8-9 or from very beginning you know it, what is environment. But here again given, that's why again we should know about the environmental concept. Very much essential, because we are living in a specific, in a definite environment where we can survive, and when we will in that environment we will only survive. So according to that environment, different environments having where the different organisms, various shapes, size, etc., various their organism lives in that environment. Okay, so what is environment? That is, now we'll again you see what is environment means. What those actually, what happened, environment derived from the word, French word, that is the environment. Environment, which means to encircle. That means those presence in your surroundings, encircles or to surround. So it can be also defined as the circumstance or condition that surrounds an organism or group of organisms. In the external condition influencing development and growth of the people, animal, plant, living, working condition, etc. That means what? Those surroundings you, their actions, their activities, every times affect in your biological process. That means those surrounding us, in our surroundings, you know, we are what? We are adapted for terrestrial environment. That means human beings and other those organisms having, those are, they are living the land living. They are, what happened? They are terrestrial. They are not able to stay in the water. Okay? They are not. They will not able to live in the watery environment because they are adapted for the terrestrial environment. That means those terrestrial lands, land living, we are land living. So our surrounding, those having living, non-living, etc., their activities are very much essentials for our life. That's why we are able to survive. That's why we are able to survive in this terrestrial environment. Not only are those are having those. So our surrounding, those long living all components having interaction of which our life is survived. Our life is able to survive, or able, our life is possible. Our life is possible. Why? Those are surroundings, living, non-living things having, their activities, their actions are very much essential for our life. And interaction of which our life is possible. That's why we are living in a terrestrial environment. Okay, or those having, they are all, they are not only living, non-living, all things, including from plants to all animals, direct or activities also needed, and non-living also. Non-living means what? Sun, air, land. Okay, all these are atmospheric temperature, everything. Those are very essential for our biological process. Otherwise, life is not possible. So interaction of which, you know, you're in a terrestrial environment, a specific temperature, you can survive. If more, then you can die. So at a limit there, after that level you can tolerable. Cold, at a, that level you can tolerable. That's why you can live in the earth, in a terrestrial. But if you go, your environment is not terrestrial environment, that's why. Yeah, your respiration going on, your oxygen. How will you able to get the oxygen? Because from the plants. So our surrounding nature of plants is very much essential. Because plants produces oxygen at daytime. And carbon dioxide, those released from our body due to the various metabolic activities. That means when the foods are broken down, at the time carbon dioxide is released, which is very toxic, which is goes out from our nostril at expiration or in the exhalation, and which are not needed by. But if carbon dioxide more, then also you will not able to survive, too much hot. So, but that carbon dioxide not needed by us, but plants needs. That's why surrounding plants, plants produce of gases, and also various activities, various benefits given by the plants, and also other living organisms also. Their activities also very much essential for our life. for our to proceed our various biological process. That's why we can survive. Okay, that is our environment, and also a non-living. That means for sun, sunlight, temperature, etc. Very much at a specific temperature we can survive. And specific temperature or different type of metabolic activities going on. That's why we're growing different stages. Again, all our life cycle is able to proceed. Water needed, water having available. Air, water, soil, land, we are everything in a land we are going and land we are again decomposed. All of you know that in the land there what will happen? Various type of microorganisms are present. So it's a very essential for decomposition of living matters. Humans, okay, no doubt, they are buried, they are burnt after death, okay? Then again mixes with the soil. But another living organism you see, when they will death, they will again decompose by microbacteria, again those are called as a microbacteria. They can decompose it and mixes with the soil. Soil become fertile. Again, plants growing on there. Those are needed for our life also, and also a lot of those are terrestrial environment living. Okay? So that is our environment. So there's a relations everywhere. Those surrounding areas, we can there relation going on, that's why there are interaction going on, that's why we're living into that. Yes. But if you compare another environment also, like that fish, suppose example fish, they will able to live in a water environment. Why? Because there are very less amount of oxygen needed. Diffuse there, those are dissolved oxygen is sufficient for them. That's why their body also modified. They can swim also, different type of, they are adapted. They are, because they can, environment is what? Water environment. Slippery body, dissolved oxygen, winds present. They can swim, different type of winds present. So they are adapted for that, they are cold blooded, not warm blooded like us. So that's why stay in the water environment. And their water, when those their environment, they can actually environment their whole life process, their whole lives, can survive in the environment. That's why their metabolic activities, those foods, those extra excretion, everything that going on in that environment. That means our food available in the plants produces a different type of foods, rice, the wheat, everything. They are provided by the plants. That are needed, that we eat, and excrete again goes to the soil. Like that plants also, like the fish also, they are in the environment, their food is present. For algae, everything goes there. That means that they are the producers. They are the consumers, and after that they can be again mixes with that environment or the soil. Actually in the soil or lab, they can again, what will happen, mixes due to the action of the microbacteria. So like the different, if you see in the biological side, then only they will concern about that living and non-living matters. But another environment, suppose social environment, those group of people around it, according to your manner of behavior. Like that community. Oh, okay, like your intellectual, but those are your surrounding environment, your personality will be different. That is also another environment. But as a biology, we will concern about the what? Living, non-living matters due to which our life is possible. That is our environment. Because their interaction is very needed for our survival. Okay, another points you see. Suppose there is a biodegradable and non-biodegradable component. That means what you know, see, some In your body, your digestion absorption already over, you see, in your alimentary canals, there are different parts, different type of digestion and digestion. After that absorption going on, you know. How it is possible? Due to the action of the enzymes. And also some mitobacterial action also. That enzymes what? Gradually broken, breaks down into smaller component, due to which finally they are able to get absorbed into the blood. So that environment is why inside the alimentary canal also, otherwise not. So inside the alimentary canal, what will happen? Enzymes are present, that's why food gradually decompose, broken down and finally absorbed, and unwanted goes on. Those they will not able to break down, undigested, they also goes out as a fecal matter. Like in the soil also, you mind it, in the soil, there are those microbacteria presence, which decompose. Okay, and mixes with the soil. They also sometimes what happen, all organ, all materials, or you may say the all organisms, they are not able to decompose them. That means all will not able to mixes fully into the soil. If they are not able to mixes with the soil, sometimes it create problems in the environment, it get to the pollution also. Or that specific actually products are nothing but the man-made mainly. Man-made mainly. Suppose plastics, plastics waste, polythenes, etc. Those are man-made. They will not mix us in the soil. But if in the soil, the soil fertility will be lost. Suppose in your specific area, more pollution you give, their plants will not able to grow. Because they are not able to grow, penetrate towards the roots will not able to collect the water, everything there creates problem. If it mixes more, because it's a man-made, not able to decompose by the plants, bacteria, soil bacteria, soil microorganisms, they're not able to decompose. But others, if you suppose your those your another product, those suppose up to dead body also. Everything they get mixes with the soil because they can be decomposed. So that is the main point. The two type of things, that means one is decomposed, another not able to decompose by the microbes. So definition is what happened? Substances that are broken down by the biological process are called biodegradable. The substances those can be broken down by the biological process, which is called the decomposition, and mixes with the soil. These are called as the what? Biodegradable components or biodegradable substances. Your daily those are household, your suppose your those are your everything, your in your home, different type of substances, they are waste product. Daily they are waste, but they are they they should be washed, they should be daily your after regulation, they are already waste product. What happens sometimes you saw your food those having those are eaten, those are not eaten by suppose your another spoiled food, etc. You will give in the soil. They will mix it, no any problem. But another, there are those having some plastic waste, glass, etc. They will, if you get the soil, they will not be in a mess. Those are mixes with the soil, those can be decomposed. Decomposed means what? Their structure will be deformed. Structure change and it will be another form. Okay? At that time, actually, some smelling also produced due to the bacterial action and gradually mixes with the soil due to its soil fertility increase. And plants able to again grow. Because plants are very needed for our survival, for our life, because oxygen only produced. So what will happen? Oxygen, food, etc. So what will happen? That is why those are get mixed, these are called a biodegradable component, those not non-biodegradable components. So that is biodegradable and non-biodegradable, you know it, and you also read more about that. That those are their daily your home, those are having our those are waste product, there what are the biodegradable, what are the non-biodegradable. For a purpose, in your book also first page, one activity given you see. And you do that activity, very much essential for the practical knowledge. What are the activity you see 15.1, there given what happened, what's happened your question given in your book you see, what's happened, those are about your waste product produced by waste product in your home. What happened about them? So for that purpose you do a activity, not a project actually, simple project may also tell, but activity what you will do? Suppose daily those your waste product from your home, you collect it. How you will collect? What you will collect? Firstly you collect like kitchen wash. What are the kitchen wash? Spoiled for food, okay? Vegetables. Tea leaves, milk products, leafy cotton, those are empty cartons, etc. And also medicines, bottle, spirits, those having old cloth, broken glass, etc. Those you are everything you collecting. Plastic waste, everything collecting. Visible part also, fruits part, everything. Those are waste product as a daily that you firstly will not first you collect it. After that, what you will need that if in your home there are such type of space, have no doubt. Other in your school also, there school also you may do it in your playground. There is a suppose space, have there. What will happen? You bury them by digging a hole, you bury them, and after that, 15 days you observe it. if suppose space not having, then what you let it take a container? No, need new container, but you collect a container. So what you did? There you put the all waste product. Okay? Then after that you give at least 15 centimeter or 5 centimeter or up to 5 centimeter you give, that is also sufficient soil and cover it. Then what will happen after you put no cover, okay, cover, that is the 55 centimeter soil you give, and after 15 days you observe it. What you observe? First point is what? List those not decomposed. That means here you list it. The which product? The plastic waste. That means you see milk product, milk packet, medicine bottle, etc. But those having your which are not decomposed. That means their structure not totally changed as it is. You list it. Second, you list it. Those gatherers changes their structures. That means they are totally decomposed. They are actually structure change, and also they are made and their structure change, and it will be able to convert to another form. That also means. Okay, that also will list it after 15 days. And also you observe it, then thirdly you see whose changes fastest, whose easily decomposed. Which gets easily decomposed, you take time, and which gets easily decomposed, you list it. So it will, what will happen, increases your practical knowledge about the biodegradable and non-biodegradable. The non-biodegradable, then you realize that those are our waste product, how hamper our environment. Those are living our way, land living, terrestrial. Those respect are, you know, without any concern, without knowing, those are everything goes to the soil. How it affect our life, how it affect the soil, how it form the soil pollution, how it create soil pollution, etc. You will at that time realize. That means you see those are biodegradable, no problems. At least you see that means easily they can decompose, you may give the soil no doubt. But those among that biodegradable, non-biodegradable also present. So what they will do? They will gradually create the soil pollution. If you give in the soil rate. So at that time you realize your practical knowledge will develop. When you do that practicals, so you try to do activities, and in this chapter actually what happened, you know, to my maximum did a reduced syllabus. Chapter 16 already omitted, so that's why it is just last chapter. Within this three sessions, session 1, session 2, session 3, your syllabus from the biology zoology part already, it will be up to that reduced syllabus. According to that reduced syllabus, only after 2 class it will be finished, because environment they are not all are needed up to 15.2.1, I think up to food chain and food way. So within 2 class, session 2, session 3, it will be finished. Okay. So environment also not, because due to the, you know, virus, coronavirus infection, the pandemic situation, syllabus also reduced. Okay, so I could actually, you read more in your home, any problem you may ask in the doubt clearing classes, and that is about our environment. Next we'll go, what is environment, their component, ecosystem, etc. in the session 2. So you do that activity, those are given by me, and your book also present, what you should do. Now, what is about the waste product, what happened? They are biodegradable, non-biodegradable components, concept you develop, and you can be also your consciousness about the environment also create, okay? And also what is environment, then different type of environment, etc. You read from the book also, and extra also reference book also you book. Any problem you may ask, you know, doubt to interest. That's all today, okay? Thank you.